Now, as we have discussed about the summer, the interesting fact about summer is that the sun, imagine this is the earth, and these are the sun rays which are moving towards this location. So when we are discussing about the earth of movement and all these things, we have to remember that the sun's rays are falling on an elevated path. So when it is on an elevated path, you don't get the exactly how does it shine on the equatorial regions. So as it is moving upwards and find it that, so the sun stands as it in the horizon. In the horizon of the region. In the horizon of the region, you don't find the full sunshine. That is the reason why it's like a place where sky meets the earth. In that point, you find the sun shining for the whole 24 hours there. So in the whole 24 hours, you don't feel anything much different even if the sun is present. It's like a small candle which is showing its light. In that way, you find the location here. It is not so seriously that sunshine is present for 24 hours. It's present 24 hours, yes, it's correct. But the sunshine's energy emitted is very less. Comparatively very less when compared to the other regions. Even though it is for 6 months there, yes, it shows its impact. The climatic condition becomes very good. The ice starts to break down. The water turns to be water itself. It does not be into the form of ice. Then many of the plants, lichens, mosses, berry fruits all start to grow up in the 6 months. Many of the animals and the birds return back to feed themselves on these fruits and all these things, which adds color for the life of the region. This is the specialty of the summer region. What about the vegetation of this region? We'll see now. So because of the excessive sun rays or the sun which is flowing for 6 months, some of the ice melts or breaks up from its mother ice and forms like icebergs and starts to flow in the various regions. Now we have discussed about the climatic conditions of the tundra region. Now the climate of tundra region is divided into two parts. We have seen summer as well as the winter. Winter is extremely cold, completely gets formed into ice. Summer is a bit better when compared to winter. All trees which are like mosses, lichens, fruit, berries, all will be start bearing. Animals and birds return back to their locations. What about the vegetation? Why the vegetation is not possible here? I think you all know what is vegetation. Vegetation is the study of the plants and the crops which grow in a particular region. So in this vegetation of the tundra region, we can't find very good vegetation because it is the region where ice dominates the land. The region where ice dominates the land. The entire soil is covered with thick layers of ice. Even in summer, you don't find the soil capability to uproot a plant. Because the trees, even if they are able to manage them, the plants, and to survive them, the winds and storms will destroy them and uproot them immediately. So immediately the trees die. So the conditions of the trees to grow here is very difficult. The major difficulty is the ice. The land is completely covered whole along the year with the permanent sheets of ice. That is the reason why this region is called permafrost. The region which is permanently frost region is called permafrost region. And this is the reason why most of the times the crops are, there are no other crops. So now, in the climatic condition where the temperatures are completely zero level and the land is completely covered with ice, we can't expect a tree to grow here. This is the reason why most of the tundra regions are treeless. So you can remember very easily, tundras are treeless. Tundras T, tree T. Tundras are treeless for most of the parts on the globe. Who lives here? Do people live here in such kind of very different type of climatic conditions? Is it possible for human beings to survive here? Yes. we have a group of people living here. Those people name is Eskimos. Now we are going to discuss about a variety of people who are able to survive in an extreme climatic conditions. The Arctic region is a very harsh climatic condition, extremely cold climatic condition, where we can't even imagine of surviving a people like us living there. But we have a group of people living here. Those people are called Eskimos. The Eskimos live in the region of Canada, Serbia, then in the northern parts of Russia, eastern edge of Russia, Alaska region. All these regions are occupied by the Eskimos, but they are not in a single group. They are in a scattered group. Now, what is the meaning of the Eskimos? The Eskimos' actual meaning is snowshoe netter. Snowshoe netter. The Eskimos literally means snowshoes, means it is completely filled with snow. The people, those are able to survive themselves in the extreme climatic conditions, are called Eskimos. And if we have two groups in the Eskimos, one is the Inuit group, the other one is the Yupik group. These two are the main divisions of people who live in the Eskimos. Eskimos are broadly divided into two categories, those are Inuit and Yupik. The literal meaning of this Inuit or Yupik in the Eskimos language is the real people or the people. So these people mainly depended on two occupations. One is hunting and fishing. So Eskimos are the people who survive in the extreme, harshy, dangerous, marshy climatic conditions, which are not at all suitable for any kind of other people who are living here, but they are able to survive here. They are living in scattered groups. Their hometown is Serbia region. Later they moved on to Canada, then they moved on to Alaska, then they moved on to Russia, other regions. So this extreme climatic condition is a home for the Eskimos, and they are divided into two groups, that is Inuits and Yupik. They literally mean that snowshoe netters. And here these people's real occupation, or the meaning of the in their language, is that real people are the people. Their main occupation is the hunting and fishing. What are the other things that they have doing it for their survival? How do they do the hunting? What they will do the hunting means what they are going to hunt. Because as per our knowledge, we don't have any animals like us, we are tiger, lion and all these things which will grow here, so that they can attack them and destroy them and then kill them to do some kind of food material for them. What is their food habits? What do they eat? Are they getting in contact with the other parts of the world? If they get into contact, what will happen now? We'll see now.